This is an interesting and complicated case. A male, 37 years old, with history of fever, note of high grade. Other symptoms are written in the starting of the video. In the starting, we see a liver and large cystic mass spherely. Now this is the question, what is this? Is this liver abscess? But before answer, it is important to rule out other causes. The liver is measured, this is grossly enlarged, 20.1 cm. Normal, this is less than 16 cm. The liver texture is normal. The gallbladder is normal. Portal vein and CBD is normal, no thrombus seen in portal vein. The pancreas is normal, no peripancreatic fluid seen. Right kidney is normal, no peripatic fluid or collection seen. Now, no other pathology seen. Again, focus at the cystic mass. There is another hyperchoric mass just posterior to the cystic mass. This is avascular and mild thick internal fluid seen. There is defect anteriorly seen with communicating with the cystic mass. Now see the echogenic line, that is the anterior surface of the liver, and there is large defect with communication with the cystic mass. Now this is clear that this hyperchoric mass is the liver abscess and ruptured into the anterior subphrenic space. The large cystic mass is not in the liver, this is anteriorly extrahepatic with thick collection of pus and fluid. Sizes are written in the video. The collection volume is 674 ml. This is large collection, and abscess is small and hyperchoric because it is ruptured. Note the movement of fluid with patient respiration and probe pressure. This is case of amebic liver abscess caused by eating contaminated food and water. Every year, the parasite causes up to 40 million of infections and up to 1 lakh deaths. Now see the right pleural fluid in lower zone. The diaphragm is intact, so main cause of this fluid is reactive. If not treated timely, the extrahepatic pathology can be present in many patients. These include lung involvement, peripatic fluid collection, GIT involvement, and retroperitoneal extension. These are the actual images of the parasite causing the infection.